So now that you understand the push-up, you made it to level 2. And you may have noticed that performing the push-up on the bench may have been easy for you, but maybe you didn't know that you had to drive the shoulders forward first in order to actually maximize that performance. But now, how do we scale it up? How do we make it harder? Well, you could bring that bench lower down. Sometimes the bench is a fixed surface, so maybe you have to just bring your feet up. It's just a matter of making that angle a little bit more shallow. But what happens when you get to the ground is that you get to the point where there's no black and white, it's kind of gray. And what we can do here is we can actually play with the legs. What I could do is I could start in a plank position or push-up position, and instead of performing a push-up with my legs with the feet together, I could just widen the stance a little bit. And all I'm doing here is making the length of my body a little shorter. When I widen the stance, my body is a little shorter, which takes a little load away from my push-up and allows me to perform this movement with a little more ease. The only difference here is that as I widen my stance, my butt has a tendency of coming out, and we don't want that because that puts a little stress on the back. So what I want you to think about is as you widen your stance, make sure you tuck your butt in. The butt should be tight, the belly should be tight, and the shoulders, once again, should be traveling forward. At the bottom of that push-up, the same position should be matched where we have a vertical forearm, or you can look at it as perpendicular to the midline. That is level 2 for push-up, and once you have that, you can bring the feet closer together until you reach the optimal or most common position.